Well, welcome you two lovely, three lovely women this morning, three goddesses. And this is great. We can get started right on time. And again, it's wonderful to have you to sit with today and to be with. I think we know what we're doing. And I think Sheila's been with us since the beginning, so we don't have to have a lot of discussion about this, a lot of reading about it. But let us just open up our chest and get some. Find your seat. That's the first thing we do in meditation. It's like, where is it? My back. It doesn't matter where you are, as long as you're on your two sitting bones, so your spine lines up, so your energy lines up, so all of your body's muscles, tendons, and nerves function better. And let's take the hands right up here and just open the chest and just open up. Oh, yeah. And exhale. Word about breathing since we follow our breath. Open up again and notice as you take a nice big breath in, what you feel expanding. Probably your chest. See if you can take the next breath so that you're also expanding your back body. A lot of our breathing apparatus, our lungs are in the back, and somehow we think if we just feel our chest pump out in the front, we're getting a good breath. But for you women, just feel your strap really expanding, your clothes against your back body, so that you're filling your entire container with your lungs and your heart and your whole chest with this life-giving oxygen. Good, take the arms in and let's take some big circles. Oh, I love to hear the crunchies down the back of my neck and my angel wings when I do that. Inhale and open. Oh, this time we're gonna leave them right up. We're gonna take a little stretch over to one side and open up that side of the chest, frequently compressed, and over to the other side. And we're gonna interlace the hands as we do and push up. Let your shoulders drop and see if you can lift your head up towards your hands. Oh, slowly pushing away anything we don't need left over from last year and starting into some new possibilities here. We're going to open our hands and receive whatever the universe is giving us today, trusting it's just what we need. Oh, so, I'll just do a little one I like, a little reading. You have all of these readings because I put it on a sheet of paper for you, so there's no magic here. You can do this yourself. Sheila, if you do not have this sheet of paper with meditation readings, let me know. I'll have Cher to go get it to you. Yeah. Step out of the traffic, the noise, the chatter of your own mind, the overwhelmingness of our world, and move into your own world, your heart center of natural peace and bliss. And maybe we will all live a little happier and calmer. My dad used to say, slow down, Don, you'll live a lot longer. Because I was very hyped when he was an engineer. But I think he was right. So, slowing down, clearing out the anxiety and regret like dental floss for the mind, we will begin choosing, now that we have our seat anchored, and we're lifting up tall so energy can move and oxygen can deliver every part of your body. We're going to choose our focal point for our extended concentration or meditation. We're going to choose, is it just the breath? Do we want to add counting on the fingers or the prayer beads? Do we have a special mantra that we've gain from some other practice? Holy Om Nam Shalom. And a good mantra is just in and out. If the mind has to think about something, it can think in and out. When the mind gets distracted, hearing, noise, thinking, acknowledge that, and then let it go. And I find a big breath, kind of brings me back again. So I'm going to be quiet. We're all going to be quiet. I may pop in just once about distraction. Other than that, we'll all be in our natural space, our heart center. So we begin in and out, in and out. No place to go, nothing to do. As best you can, relaxing the forehead, the eyebrows, relaxing the jaw, lips, and tongue. Resting shoulders down and away. Relaxing arms, wrists, and fingers. Nothing to do. Relaxing legs and feet, ankles and toes. No place to go. Nothing to do and no place to go but to be in your own natural peace and bliss for the next bit of time, which I will watch for you. In and out. In and out. Allow your breath to deepen them. Try. Let go of any little chills and momentum. You might want to put your head just gently move a little bit this way and that way. Whatever. Neck and shoulders and right toward the end. Watch your body just sway over to one side. And the other. To come back to center and let your head turn and look over one shoulder, but not too far, just the way it's comfortable. And then over the other shoulder. Slowly opening eyes and looking at all of wonders and beauty that really offered us. So let's just try for a moment. The last minute or two, what we did last week. Can y'all see the camera? Focus on the camera. I'd like to use a real one, but I'm not sure it's all. And you can try this at home, it's quite effective. So just stare at something. Just stare at it. And close your eyes for just a breath or two and see it. And check it out again. And just repeat this until you can actually see in your mind's eye. Friends at home can do this also with a safe candle they might have at home or any object. Just seeing in your mind's eye, concentrating on this so much with your eyes open. And close our eyes, we can still see the image. Reminding ourselves, it's always a practice. It's not something that we need to achieve. All of these traditions are practices, just a practice. To gain a bit. So, shanti, shanti, peace, peace, peace. Peace among hearts, among hearts. Peace in our minds. And peace in our words and actions, so they are a support for ourselves and for others. That's my mistake. Thank you for coming. I don't know if I've done that. I'm sorry. It's a yoga thing, but make a joyful noise. We've got ourselves a nice day out there with low winds.